Hello, welcome back. It's Dan, and I am in the basement down at Guitar Interactive once again. And we've nipped across the road to our friends at dv247.com. And I spoke to Luke there and said, can we try out some basses? And he has let us review this rather cool Epiphone EB-3 bass, this sort of SG style, Gibson-esque instrument. Right, let's have a close look. Up to the headstock, here we go. Nice classic Epiphone design there. And we've got two aside tuning keys and these nice big elephant ears. And I'm gonna spin the bass over and have a look at those. Let's just wind these volume controls down. There we go. And nice little open gear tuning keys here. And you can also see that as I flip the bass over, it's an angled back headstock. So you know I'm a fan of that already. You know, I've said it a million times. There we go. So a nice break angle over the nut. And it's very, very slim indeed. Feels like a really skinny jazz bass with quite a rounded profile, like a vintage type profile on the back of the neck itself. Although it's lovely covered and lacquered, we've got a mahogany neck under here and a rosewood fretboard with these rather cool markers. Hopefully you can see those nice and clearly. And then for you visually, I'm gonna see that some little dots on top of the neck. Only Diddy ones, but since we've got such a dark finish on the neck, then hopefully they're gonna show up in the dark a little bit. Speaking of which, let's have a look at the finish on the back, kind of round it over nice and slowly. So hopefully you can see the profile on the back of the neck. And as we come down to the body, which is also mahogany, nice warm sound. Strap button, where the heel is, I suppose. It's not really a heel, I suppose, it's a set neck. This lovely glossy finish. Round back to the front. And we can have a close up of this classic design. We have nice, big, chunky pickup. Do you know what I like about these is it doesn't matter what bass you put them in. They always sound similar. Some pickups, you know, they really do suit different instruments because they have their own character and bring out certain characters of instruments. But this always just sounds big, round and fat. So I like these a lot. So you're gonna hear that soloed in a minute to hear what I'm talking about. And then we have a little mini pickup over in the bridge position. This is great if you're the kind of player who finds that pickups in this area are a bit in the way. 3-point mount bridge with a quick release slots. So string goes straight in on the ball end, bang, straight up to the tuning key, no problem at all. String changes are gonna be nice and quick. And then we have four controls, two volume controls, a volume control for this pickup, volume control for this pickup, and then a tone control for each rather than having just one master tone. And then this rather cool, like chicken head control switch that selects either the bridge pickup on its own, both together in parallel, and then finally the front pickup on its own, say. Now there are some little labels and things that are still left on this bass. That's because it's for sale, so I don't want to like be removing any labels or protective coverings or anything like that. So don't worry about those. And we've got this nice little pick guard finishing off the styling on the front of the instrument. Okay then, so in the intro you heard everything turned up to 10. That's what I like. But what we'll do is let's have a listen to that front pickup on its own. So volume up, let's turn that one down. There we go. So this is the front pickup on its own with the tone control all the way open. So you're getting all that top end as well. Here we go. Rounding the tone control all the way down. Let's have a listen to how that slopes off the top end. I mean, that's kind of an iconic bass tone and I've literally done nothing to create it. We are going straight out to DI here, so straight out the back of my amp, which is set pretty much flat. and we've got that lovely, I want to say kind of like honky middle sound. I want to put it through a big Marshall stack or something like that. That sounds great. I'll just play with that sound all the time. That's really nice. Okay, let's move on. We're going to run out of time otherwise. So, back pickup on its own. Let's do the tone control all the way open. Then quickly all the way down so you can hear the breadth of the control. And then finally, to top it off versus the introduction, this is both pickups on, but with the tone controls on both all the way down. So you're getting a nice rounding off of both at the same time. Nice. So I could have spent a lot more time going through all the individual possible settings, but hopefully you can hear like the ends of each. So the brightness and the very low end bassiness that is available from the instrument. For me, I would go straight back to that front pickup, roll the tone off and go for that little mid-range honk type thing. Very, very cool indeed. So that rounds up the tones on the EB-3 here. Very, very quickly, one thing I didn't mention, actually, rather than the short scale, which was the original model, this one's been extended out to 34-inch scale. So he's a little bit longer on the neck. So that's going to bring with you certain tonal advantages. But if you are smaller in body size, then maybe you want to seek out the short scale version and have a little bit of a play on that one. I think they're both going to be really, really cool to listen to and play. That really is it. I think we've got a great sounding little instrument here. Nice neck carve, which I think is going to be suitable for all hands. It's a well-known brand as well, so there's that, which is also an advantage too. So there we go. I hope you enjoyed checking it out. This is the Epiphone EB-3, and of course I'll catch you in another review soon. Thanks ever so much for watching, and I'll see you again.